channel. So today I'm going to be showing you guys how I do my eyebrows. This was a requested tutorial, even though I mentioned it so that you guys would request it. But I've been wanting to do a new brow tutorial because I haven't done one in a really long time, and I feel like it's about time that I do a new one. I just wanted to kind of like rehash some of the things that I've said before in my tutorial. If you want to see my original eyebrow tutorial, I will post it in the description box where I explain eyebrow shape and all of that. But this one is more about just how I do my brows. I'm gonna explain to you guys how I do my brows, explain a little brow anatomy, and I hope that you guys like it. So if you wanna see how I get my brows, keep watching. First, we're gonna start off by, I'm knocking everything over. Just brushing through our brows first with a spool. A spool looks like this. It's that little squiggly thing at the end of an eyebrow brush. You wanna get an eyebrow brush? Obviously. If you don't know these things by now, child, where you been? This is an eyebrow brush from It Cosmetics, and I'm just going to be using this to comb through my eyebrows first. So I'm going to take my favorite eyebrow pomade, which is by Anastasia, and it is the Dip Brow Pomade. I really want to get the ColourPop eyebrow stuff because I heard that it's really nice, but I don't have it yet. I'm going to be using this one. Is I just like to start in the center of my eye. Now I fill in my brows pretty generously. I try not to shy away from the filling in of the brows. I like my brows to start where my nose contour would start. So like right here on either side of the point of my nose is where I like for my brows to start. I know that's a little too far in for some people, but I feel like too many people start their eyebrows like at the beginning of their eye, which I find makes your eyes look more far apart. And I don't like to look like a fish, so that's why I fill my eyebrows in more into the center. It is hot in this piece. These lights are super bright. But yeah, I'm just gonna start filling them in right here. I'm starting here at the beginning of the arch of my brow, and I'm just filling that in. And as you can see, I've gotten my brows done. I get my eyebrows threaded. I don't like to get them waxed or anything. I like to get them threaded because I get a more precise shape. But as you can see, I know pretty much where the shape of my eyebrow is. You can feel your brow bone and kind of feel where you want it to go if you don't have hair there. But for me, I know pretty much where my eyebrows go. So I'm just filling them in where I like my shape to be. If you don't know what shape you want, draw it out, like draw it on a sheet of paper, and just kind of get the shape that you would like. I usually like my arch to be like diagonal, as you can see through my pupil. So instead of it just being straight like right here or way over here, I like my arch to be diagonal through my pupil, so it gives me like an eye lift, you know? Like I said, I have a diagram. There's a diagram. I'm gonna put it on the screen, but there's a diagram of how I like my eyebrow shape to be so that it flatters my face the best way possible. So I'm just filling my eyebrow in with this Dip Brow Pomade in Ebony, the color is Ebony. Just filling the brows in. And I get lighter as I get to the front here, so they kind of does a fading effect. Because your brows, this is my pet peeve, guys. When people's brows stop, like they just stop. Like they halt, like a stop sign. Like, no, your eyebrows are not supposed to be blocked off in the front. That's not cute. Kind of fade them out or make sure they're a little bit lighter in the front, guys. Don't just block off your eyebrows. But so yeah, this is, I fill my eyebrows in pretty heavily at first, and then I go through and fix them after. That's pretty much how I wanna do my brows. So I'm gonna fill the other one in. Remember that your eyebrows are sisters, they're not twins, okay? So if they don't look exactly the same, that's fine. You just want them to look similar, not exactly the same, but similar. And I like to do my brows last now. I used to do my brows like first, but now I like to do them last because I notice that I'm really heavy-handed when it comes to powder and stuff, and it gets all in my brows and messes them up. And I just, if I'm creating a masterpiece, I don't wanna go over it and mess it up. So in the front, if you want, you can turn your brush sideways and kind of brush inwards towards the point of your nose where you want it to stop. As you can see, that's like way too close together, but you can always go back and fix it. I'd rather do too much and go back and fix it than not do enough. I'm just gonna brush through the front part here with my spoolie to kind of fix that harshness in the front. Like I said, you don't want it to be too harsh. And if I were using a pencil, I would just like kind of pencil in that front part, but I'm using this, so. There's a different method when I use pencils. I have a different method, so I might do another video with using a pencil. After I do that, I'm going to take my concealer brush and I'm going to take a concealer or something that is lighter than my skin tone to highlight my brow bone. I'm gonna use this color CoverFX palette, and this is in the shade In Deep. And I'm going to take the lightest color at the top here, and I'm gonna just follow underneath, and I'm just gonna follow that line underneath to highlight. Now, over time, I've gotten really good at not making this look a hot mess. Back in the day, I used to do a way too light color, and I used to do way too much underneath, and it would just not blend right, and it would make me look like I have halo brows. You don't wanna have halos around your brows, guys, okay? The day of wearing super light concealer around your entire eyebrow, those days are over, okay? We want our eyebrows to look decent. We don't want them to look like we glued them to our face. So now I use a darker color at the front underneath so that, you know, it blends better with this part of my eye. You don't wanna highlight underneath here too, because then it's gonna look like you put concealer underneath your eyebrows. I mean, I'm all for a sculpted look, don't get me wrong, but I do not think that it's necessary for you to put super bright concealer all the way in here. I just don't. But to each his own. I just feel like if you're going for a more natural look, it's better to not do all of that. And that's why I suggest getting a palette with more than one color in it, because, you know, some days you just want it to be a little more subtle. Some days you want a little extra pop. The concealer is great if your eyebrows are growing out or if they're growing back and you have hairs that you want to cover up. Concealer will cover up those hairs for you. Taking this same color down here again and going on the top. You don't want to use a super bright color up here. I just prefer to use a skin tone color. It just makes it look a little bit more natural and a little bit more seamless with the rest of your foundation. Once I've cleaned up around the edges of my brows, pretty much done. The only thing that I like to do now is set my brows. I got this new brow setting stuff. This is called Model in a Bottle Long Lasting Eyebrow Sealer. And this stuff is magic in a bottle, okay? It is a freaking amazing. If you have not tried this, it is amazing. I got it from Camera Ready Cosmetics. And it's super duper like heavy duty. So if you don't want your eyebrows to be stuck, like make sure you want your eyebrows to be exactly where they are for the rest of the day, because they're not moving, trust me. This is like hairspray, but for your eyebrows. So you wanna just lightly brush through your hairs. And whew, that is, you see how that's running down? That's way too much. But yeah, this stuff is really like liquidy, so be careful with it because it is very watery, so you want to be careful. But as you can see, it kind of just sets the brows into place, and once it dries though, it does not move. Like you can like literally wipe across your eyebrow and nothing will move. Like it will not come off, it won't move. It sets those eyebrows in place. Now this is perfect for people who sweat a lot, or if you are going to be somewhere with water, or that's somewhere that's wet or humid, and you find that your eyebrows like transfer, they come off, or they move, like the hairs move out of place, this is perfect for you, because they won't move. Very lightly brush up the middle here, just to kind of blend out those brows in the front. That's how I do my brows. It's really simple, but I just wanted to kind of like show you guys how I did them, like with a slow talk through kind of format, because I know some people want to know how I do them. I do have like a more extensive version of how to do brows, but this is pretty much the easiest way that I know how to do it. So I hope that you guys enjoyed this tutorial. I hope that it was helpful to you. If it was, give me a thumbs up. Let me know how you like it. And if you guys want me to do more tutorials, like in-depth tutorials. And yeah, that's pretty much it. I will talk to you guys in my next video, okay? Bye.